Hey guys, it's your girl Jazmin, and welcome to Culture Shock. Get shocked while listening to undiscovered artists coast to coast. Be sure to tune in every week, and I'll be interviewing the hottest indie artists in your city. Yo, 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 we back at it with Culture Shock. We got my boy Wave Chapelle with us today. How you doing, Wave?
What's good? What's good? I'm feeling good. You know what I'm saying? It's a good day.
Yeah? How long are you in the city, bro?
I got one more week here in Memphis, then I got to hit the road. I'm doing a couple more events. I got one in Milwaukee. I'm going to shoot out to L.A., and I'm going to throw an event out there as well.
All right, perfect, perfect. So I brought you in today because I can say without a doubt, I admire your branding, like your layout for you. I got your Instagram pulled up, got you. It's inspirational. Like, it's just like...
Content.
It's perfect, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, your content's perfect. It fits well with everything you got going. So today, we're going to talk about branding.
Okay.
As an indie artist.
Yeah.
Because you're doing this from the ground up. You're paying your own photographer. You're handpicking your photographers. You're paying them. You're handpicking the person that's doing your content for you. The person that's doing your videography. You know, the people that you want on your social media, you're choosing to put them out there.
Right.
Because you don't have somebody kind of controlling what you got going and controlling your brand. So we're going to talk about that for a little bit today.
Yeah, let's do
it. So just give us a little bit of knowledge, you know what I'm saying? Like, how did Wave transition from whatever the hell your Instagram looked like before? what day was it? Before August 17th, 2016, when you had the little lock sticking out from the side over at
Complex.
Complex.
Yeah.
You know.
Pretty much, I just like, well, one, Instagram is like, I feel like it's very important for artists because it allows you to show your brand to, you know, people that follow you, you know, and it shows it in depth, not just like a quick glimpse. Like, you can see kind of like your personality, what this person look like, or what do they like, what kind of color palettes do they like, you know, all the way down to stuff like that. You know, some people like to filter all their pictures dark, or some people like it light. So I think it really just give you a chance to I guess shape your image, you know what I'm saying? And that's part of branding. Like, what's your image? What are your you know, again, what do you look like? What do you like to do on your spare time? Like, another thing is like your story. Like, I update my story a lot, and I just show like my everyday life, you know what I'm saying? And I don't got to be doing nothing spectacular. Like, it may be
fish tacos yesterday.
right it may be like what I'm eating, what I like to drink, or you know, what my favorite piece of candy is, you know what I'm saying? Just simple stuff like that. And I think that's also a part of brand building, for especially for independent artists who, like, independent artists, we don't really have that many outlets unless you just like really popping, you know what I'm saying? So if you just starting off, Instagram is one of the outlets where you can showcase your brand, what you look like, and you know, really get in tune with the fans. And so that's one of the things I try to do with my Instagram. I try to just, you know, add in what I'm doing in my everyday life, also, you know, with the music and post videos and things like that. Oh, I also got a new logo too. Like, that's my it's my main profile picture, and I think people really like that. And you know, I just want to shout out my guy Matt. He did he was really dope with designing that monogram for me and logo. So yeah.
Because definitely, as an independent artist, you have control over everything. So some people that are starting out that are independent, they want to transition. They want to sign that contract. You know what I'm saying? They want to do it.
Yeah.
But this is the time to really, like, you have an opportunity to have true fans. Like,
yeah,
people who will ride for you no matter what.
Right.
You cut all your hair off, die and die blonde, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
People that's been rocking, riding the wave, you know what
right.
I'm saying? They gonna be there with you because they see the transition, they see what you got going, you know what I'm saying? They
Facts.
See that you love fanny packs, so if somebody wanna send my boy Wave a fanny pack,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? He got one for every outfit.
Definitely. yeah, like, I feel like, well, just to touch on, like, being an independent artist and, like, people wanting to sign, I don't feel like it's nothing wrong with, you know, feeling like going to the next level. Like, I'm all for that. It's all about just, one, what's comfortable for you, two, if you're ready, and then three, like, it got to be the right situation. Like, you know, by no means am I, I guess, people going to like major deals and stuff like that. I'm just in my current situation. I'm independent, and it's the best situation for me right now at this level, because I can, like you said, just control everything, make sure I control the content, create and control how much, you know, content I can put out there. You know what I'm saying? There's nothing really like holding me back or stopping me.
And you have leverage.
Yeah.
When you can go, when somebody comes to you and be like, all right, we want to sign you. Or if you go to somebody, mm-hmm. and they say, you know, well,
we can do this for you.
We can do this for you, but yeah. you're doing it for yourself.
Exactly.
Like, that gives you some leverage. You're on the same playing field. It's like,
right.
I can keep doing this without you.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can give me the money and we can make this work.
Right. You know, yeah, they got to put some respect on your name when you come in there with your own things, basically. And I feel like... Nipsey Hussle is one of the people that really does it well, like, these days, in, like, 2018. He's somebody that really shows how to, you know, as an independent, how to get it, and then to make that transition to the major labels. Like, the whole Victory Lap rollout, all that was crazy, because he went in the label and was like, look, I don't necessarily need y'all, but let's we can create a partnership and make this thing go through the roof. And so I think that's, like, the best route to go, you know what I'm saying?
When it comes down to it, I feel you. So we're going to wind down a little bit and throw out a couple tracks for you guys. Mm-hmm. Please make sure you listen to New Wave. You're going to get a little taste of that in a second. We'll be right back with you.
Yeah.
Look, new wave, hope you ready for that. Up next, man, I'm probably that. Coming back with the quality raps. I'm trying to win, fuck a lottery scratch. Peep game, show you how to react. When they ask me how to stack, put the knowledge in raps. Cause nothing more honest is that. When I holler, y'all hollering back. And fuck Twitter, Instagram, they hit me like, follow me back. I'd rather lead today, I'd rather lead the way. I didn't ride the wave, I just be the wave. No one ever taught me to be this way. Whether I blow up or not, nigga, either way. Ayy, look, my influence was felt. I'm giving the people my truest self. I'm really authentic, I'm true to myself. I'm Santa Claus, nigga, you was the elf. I get on my grind, use all my talkers. That shit I can't waste, so I'm using my belt. Independent, I ain't using no help. Cause they gon' try to go put you on the shelf. Hold up, nigga, let me get this shit straight. This ain't just another gimmick for the clickbait. Do it big, make them big mad, make them big hate. Might just make a million on a mixtape, nigga. I'm too good to fold, ayy. I'm too great to wait, yeah. I'm too blessed to stress, nigga. I'm too strong to break. Hold up, I'm too lit to quit, ayy. Don't tell me I can't. Yeah, I'm too on the field, found a new way. I'm too strong to break, man, it's the new wave, yeah. Hey, nigga, yeah, this a new wave. Yeah, hey, look, hey, I'm too good to fall, I'm too great to wait. I'm too blessed to stress, I'm too strong to break. I'm too lit to quit, don't tell me I can't. I'm too on the field, this the new wave, yeah. Young king got the heart of a lion, ay. Stand tall, but I'm hardly a giant, ay. Killing shit when I'm hardly trying, ay. Man, why all these raps be lying, hold up. I make the money stat like this, ay. I come on the track like this, ay. I'm just having fun, get it done, number one. Even when a nigga rap like this, I know how to hustle, I'ma stack my chips. If I'm broke at five, make a stack by six. Gymnastics, that's that flip. How a nigga lose it all, make it back that quick. I don't really ever take a nap, that's it. Roll the dice, I don't ever really crap that shit. My name coming up like Dame in the clutch. Know it's my time, watch a nigga tap my wrist. Hold up, I hit the game winner on the lame, nigga. Switch the lane quick and not a bank bigger. Gassing up, filling up the tank, nigga. Killing it to make a killing, what you think, nigga? Yeah, hold on, let me get this shit straight. This ain't just another gimmick for the clickbait. Eating on these niggas, watch a nigga fix a quick play. Might just do a million on the mixtape. I'm too good to fold. Ay, I'm too great to wait. Yeah, I'm too blessed to stress. Nigga, I'm too strong to break. Hold up, I'm too lit to quit. Ay, don't tell me I can't. Yeah, I'm too on the field. Found a new way, I'm too strong to break. Man, this the new wave, yeah. Ay, nigga, yeah, this a new wave. Yeah, ay, look, ay, I'm too good to fall, I'm too great to wait, I'm too blessed to stress, I'm too strong to break, I'm too lit to quit, don't tell me I can't, I'm too on the field, this the new wave, yeah.
We'll be back right after this next track.
Thank you. precious. I be going in, all these niggas inconsistent. I been working, all my bitches think I'm missing. Got 100 missed calls on my iPhone 7. Working round the clock, 7-11. I put on for my city, they treat me like a legend. I got 100 missed calls on my iPhone 7. They blowing me up. I had to switch it up, I had to pick it up, I had to take a loss, just to become a boss. I'm on my own shit, king on the throne shit, I'm in the zone, bitch, leave me alone, bitch. Hey, if you got some money, nigga, hit me on my 7, I ain't selling, heard they telling, you in hell, I'm in heaven, baby, I'm way, way up, watching the game play up. Soon as they see a nigga winning, I've been the man since the beginning. All of my DNA is in your lifestyle, you copy what I do. All these bitches like mouth, what am I supposed to do? Give them the work, I gotta get it, man, I need it first. Came from the dirt, I need a billy, I know what it's worth. Niggas are scared of the truth, cause it hurt.
I got 100 missed calls on my iPhone 7. Working round the clock, 7-11. I put on for my city, they treat me like a legend. I got 100 missed calls on my iPhone 7. They blowing me up.
We're back. So, guys, I promise you, while you're listening to this, you have the opportunity to just click over after this podcast is over and listen to the full project. But Wave, mm-hmm. Next thing you want to talk about, I mean, you're traveling all the time. So how did you get to the point? I know how you started out, but mm-hmm. How did you get to the point to where you're able to just pick up and go? You're getting ready to leave Memphis, go back to Milwaukee, leave Milwaukee, go to LA, or maybe vice versa.
Yeah. I guess just hard work, you know what I'm saying? Well, starting off, I came to Memphis in like 2013, 2014. I was going to LeMoyne, and you know what I'm saying? I was like this new kid in Memphis or whatever, and really not too many people knew who I was. And but everybody knew I was different. Like, people could look at me and tell that, yo, this dude is not from here. We don't know where he's from. And you know, as I was in school, I just started. That was actually my first time being solo as an artist. Like, back when I was doing music in Milwaukee in high school and in middle school, I was in a group. So when I first went to college, that was my first time ever being like solo. And so I'm working on all this music, and I linked up with this producer named Colway. Shout out to Colway. Like, he really helped develop the sound, and like, he really gave me a place to record and stuff like that. And once I dropped that first project, it was really just off to the races. Yo Gotti had reached out to me. We did some work together. We did like a whole project together that came out. It's called Chapter One. Once that dropped, then everything really just started rolling in. It really gave me a dope platform to you know, reach the fans, and people were just like, yo, this kid is dope, we gonna rock with his music. And after that, I just continued to build my following. I did a tour with Spitta, well, Currency, y'all know him as Currency. I did the drive-in theater tour, and yeah, once that finished, I went completely independent again. And yeah, man, I just been staying consistent, just making sure I drop music and work, man. And I feel like traveling, to touch on the traveling part, is very is vital to an independent artist, because it's one thing to be on the internet and, yeah, you can touch people all over the world. But by traveling, like, you're literally touching the ground and touching people in these different places. Like, if I'm in Memphis, people see me at the mall or something, like, oh, man, we just seen Wave here. Like, people remember that. They're never gonna forget that. That sticks with people. Or if you go, when I go to Milwaukee or go to LA or, you know, whatever place you go to, I just think it's important for independent artists to, at some point, plan to travel, because you wanna, as you push your brand and your music online, you also wanna, you know, do the groundwork too. So, yeah. So that's, yeah, that's just like why I like to travel. I do travel. And I'm at a point where I can travel because, you know, I just stay consistent and keep working and, you know.
So I'm going to assume that, you know, starting out as an artist, I'm not going to use myself as an example because that would be kind of trash. But as an artist, you starting out, you got a couple follows here and there. You're smart. You make your Instagram page a business profile so you can see where your fans are at.
Mm-hmm.
You contact. Who do you contact to make sure that when you come to the city, the first time you come, you probably not going to go to perform, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You're going to go so you can make contacts, but what type of person do you look for to kind of give you that avenue so you can really break into that target market so that you have the opportunity to perform at, you know, a show that's going to be of some benefit to you as an artist and not something that's, you know, just...
I would say, well, one, my thing isn't to necessarily perform all the time. Like, when I go to places, it could be simple as just linking with a producer or an engineer. Like, you know what I'm saying? Before I go to a place, I may link with somebody online, like a producer or engineer or this guy's a photographer, anything like that. You go there, you know, link with them. You know, y'all work, and over time you just build that relationship. So, you know, luckily for me, I've been able to build relationships with people all over. You know, I know producers here, I know venue owners here, or, you know, engineers here. So when I touch down, I have people to link with, and that I can just either kick it with, show me around the city, like what's popping in the city, what places do I need to be. For example, I just recently went to Atlanta. And I know my boy DJ Money Green, he really just showed me around. Like, we didn't really have nothing specifically planned, but he was like, yo, you know, rock with me. Like, you know, we'll go to this event tonight. We'll go here. We end up going to the studio. So, you know, you just got to link up, man. Being an artist is definitely all about linking up, you know, finding this, and not just anybody, like, because that's where the fake stuff come in, where people just try to, oh, let's build, fam, and, like, y'all don't really rock with each other. Like, you want to find somebody that you really rock with, you know, just build with it, man. Build that relationship, and then, you know, bust a move.
Yeah, it's all about the vibes. Like, you don't want to, you know, put that energy out to somebody who's not going to, like, take that energy in a positive way and actually want to help you. We're going to simmer down once again and hit you with a couple more hits from Wave.
Feel the waves swimming in your ocean, baby. I'm caught in the day. You got the shit that drive me crazy. I feel the waves swimming in your ocean, baby. I'm caught in the day. Feel the weight. Baby girl, I'm Aquarius, know you feel the weight. I saw you by yourself like the other day. But I'm right here, right with you. Wouldn't have that shit another way. Passive, aggressive on the gram. Talking about you want a man, but you looking at the man. I'ma pull up for the one time. Lay down like the verse hook with the punchline. Know you need someone to pull up on you all the time. Not sometime, but
waves. Days. You got the shit that drive me crazy. I feel the waves swimming in your ocean, baby.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm caught in the days. You got the shit that drive me crazy.
Yeah, yeah. I'm the one you should hit up when you feeling different.
Know that you ready for something real, cause it's been a minute. You know who the one that held you down when them niggas didn't. Got the time and I'm down to spin it. Caught up in your wave, now I'm swimming. Yeah, yeah, gotta tell me how you do that. Gotta show me how you move that. Gotta show me where the nudes at. I'm just seeing where you move at. Yeah, you know I'm the one to pull up all the time. Not just sometimes, hey, but sometimes.
We'll be back right after this next track.
Look, look, put work, why hate? Work, need it now, why wait? Dishing out up for the bait. Nah, get better, Stephen A. Whoa, I can't hear the haters talk. I can't see the haters hate. Hey, gotta get it every day. Gotta get it every day. Need it now, why wait? Need it now, why wait?
One final question for you.
Yeah, what's up?
Real talk. So, how did you build your team?
That's a good question. I didn't necessarily build my team. I really just came into it with people that I rock with, like, that I've been cool with since, like, day one, that I grew up with. You know what I'm saying? I think that's the easiest way to do it. Not saying
it,
that
it is. It
not
is
saying true. That you shouldn't go out there and like find people that you can trust and like just build with. But you know what I'm saying? I just thought it felt easier to just, you know, come in with the people that I came up with, because you don't really have no issues about like, oh, can I trust this person? Or, and y'all just vibe with each other. It's easier to work. You know, you can be an artist and trust that people will do what they got to do.
Definitely. We're very music focused mm-hmm. on this podcast, you know, mm-hmm. we're bringing in. But facts. For all those who are creative, you know, videographers, photographers,
yeah,
the people who are creating platforms,
mm-hmm.
you got to have a team behind you, because at some point it's going to get heavy. And it's all about, you know, having people around you that you can trust.
Absolutely.
And it's easier that way. It's easy to build. And at the end of the day, we're all here to provide,
mm-hmm.
to make money, mm-hmm. live a good life. Mm-hmm. But it's better to do that with people you really rock with.
Facts. Facts.
So I just wanted to hear that from you. Cause
oh, yeah. I mean, you definitely need a team, man. A team is so important. Like, if you try to do, like, far as music, you know what I'm saying? I'm not sure about, like, photography and stuff like that. But music, if you try to do that all by yourself, you're going to be overwhelmed by, like, the middle point, and then you're just going to be like, bro, I can't do it. That's how you're going to feel. So, yeah, it's definitely important to have a team. You know what I'm saying? Even if, like, the person that's on your team ain't, like, a specific role, like, just moral support, you know what I'm saying? I feel like that counts as being on your team. Somebody that shows you moral support, supports you all the way, like, that's part of being on your team, so.
Somebody that takes you in the middle of the night and be like, hey, man, you gonna make it.
Yeah, man, don't stop. Keep going.
Like, 3 a.m. Like motivational text. That's all you need. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I need those, too. Somebody send me a DM or something. Be like, hey, Jazz, it's all good. You gonna make it. We rock with you.
Oh, man.
But yeah, guys, I really enjoyed talking to you, Wave.
Yeah.
Dab me up one time.
Already,
you know
already,
what I'm saying?
Already. I appreciate
all right,
it.
All right. So go ahead and let us know what's going on with you. You've been in the city for a minute. You had your listening party. So let us know what's up next.
Yeah. So after New Wave, I actually got an album already done. You know what I'm saying? Like, this whole summer, I've just been recording a bunch of music. I probably recorded at least 40 songs. And I only put 7 songs out on New Wave. So, not necessarily that. I think I was just trying to, one, I knew that I wanted to just give like a small sample out, because people have been really waiting to hear like music from me. So, you know, 7 song EP, let them rock with that. And I've been working on the album behind it that's coming, following that up. So y'all can expect that very, very soon. The music is crazy. Like, if you like New Wave, you'll like the next project, because the production is even bigger. I'm definitely in my bag, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it's going to be more music, more videos, just more.
So with the EP New Wave, are we going to get a new wave? Because I saw in your story, you cut a couple locks out.
Oh.
I almost had a heart attack, because you inspired me to go ahead and get off my ass and get mine started.
Nah, man, on my gram, I was like, well, this is what it was. I was doing my hair, actually, you know what I'm saying? Because I'd be having to, like, you know, put it in a ponytail and stuff like that. And I had some, like, new growth that I got bored and twisted that ended up turning into dreads. They got kind of long. So I'm like, man, these not even as long as all my dreads. So I just cut those off. And everybody know that I got dreads. So I thought it would be funny to, you know, post, like, the dreads in my hand. Like, damn, okay, did he? And the album is called New Wave. So the joke was, like, new wave, new me. You know what I'm saying? But, nah, I didn't cut them off yet. But I might. I might. We'll see.
You scared me.
It's gonna be wave either way, you know what I'm saying? Dreads, no dreads, the music gonna be dope, and I think the people gonna rock with it.
Yeah, I definitely believe that. So you guys will be back next week. All love, no hate. Peace.
Hey.